Hey everyone, it's Paul with your Bold Prophets Daily. And today I am going to do something a little bit different. I am going to get into something that we talk about at Prophets Unlimited and across my services all the time, which is called Rules of the Game. And I'm going to deal with three rules of the game. And rules of the game are basic tenets of speculating, investing that I feel most regular investors, most new investors just never get that guidance about. And as a result, they end up making these mistakes. And as a result, end up losing a lot of money and then giving up and then later on, missing out on huge gains. So I want to talk about three important rules of the game. And we'll have a PDF file where we have the rules of the game that you can click on and read and check out for yourself. There are a few additional rules. However, I want to deal with the three most important rules of the game. And the number one rule, the one thing that I repeat endlessly across all of my updates, is never make an all-in bet on any single stock. Now, many of you be thinking, well, Paul, all I have is X dollars, Y dollars, and how can I do anything other than that? I understand. And one of the ways that you can avoid doing that is you can, if you are going to buy one single stock, you can buy a kind of stock called an ETF, which is an aggregation of 20, 30, 50, 100, in some cases 500 stocks. And that is something that you can do. And for example, if you go and look at my Stix trade, go across my YouTube channel, you'll see that this is comprised of five ETFs, and each ETF has many, many stocks in it. So that's one way you can get around that. Now, let me go back as to why it's important to not make an all-in bet on any single stock. Like say, for example, you know, you're picking a stock like Apple or something like that. You never want to bet all your money on one single company for any number of reasons. Number one, all of your money is now in one company. And obviously, if it goes up, you're pretty happy. However, if it goes down, now you've lost a lot of money. And now if you're terribly wrong, you've caught it at the wrong point in time where it's going to collapse in price by 30%, 50%, 80%. Now you're sitting in a lost position for a long period of time. If something were to happen to the company, they went bankrupt. Now you've got all of your money sitting in one company. It can go to zero. And the other thing that many people may not think about is that you may pick the stock at a point where it's going nowhere. And now other companies are going up. And what you will end up doing is perhaps having to sell out of the stock and to try and catch up with the market by owning other stocks. And you'll just keep flipping from one company after the other. Again, continually making all-in bets and sort of chasing the market and never making money. And so this is why I tell our readers to have a portfolio. In other words, instead of making an all-in bet, I say a minimum of five stocks. A minimum of five stocks, that's minimum. That's not the ceiling. It's not the maximum. It's the minimum of five stocks. And that way you have a small portfolio where even if you're getting one stock wrong, you have four stocks that can work well. And a good example of a mini portfolio is our stuff portfolio that I talk about on this channel a lot, which is Spotify, Tesla, Uber, and Facebook, which is up nearly 100% thus far. And if you go and look at it, you'll see that each stock has performed at a slightly different timescale. Initially, it was Tesla that was up, and then Facebook went up, and now Spotify is up as well. Uber is still down. The benefit of that is that it allows you to hold on to companies even though they have gone down from your purchase price. And many of you may not know, however, stocks rise over time as their businesses grow and as people come to own it, they come and bid the stock up, and those represent gains in your portfolio. If you only own one stock, you have only given yourself one chance to win, and you want to give yourself ultimately many chances to win. So rule number one is never make an all-in bet on any single stock. Rule number two is have a portfolio, minimum of five stocks, minimum of five stocks. All right, so this third one, many people will think like, Paul, you're crazy. All right. So we've established that you don't want to make an all-in bet at any single stock because that can be bad for any number of reasons. And you want a portfolio. That way you give yourself many chances to win. It also allows you, in case you've made a mistake in terms of timing or in terms of stocks, it gives you other ways to make money. The third thing is that many people do is they buy all of their stock all at once. And many of you might be thinking, well, Paul, how else would I do this? Like how would you buy your stock more than one way? And so what I tell our readers to do is to buy their stock in small slugs. And that's just the word that came to me when I think about it. In other words, in little bit pieces, try and target the days when the stock market is down. Try and target the days when your particular stock has gone down and when there's no real reasoning for it. And that way you are able to capture and take advantage of the volatility that is there in the stock market day after day after day. The stock market is volatile day after day. If a big seller wants to come and sell your stock, they are going to cause that price to go down. If a big buyer comes in, they're going to cause that price to go up. So it's to your benefit to buy into either periods like the crash or periods when there is some rumor going around that something's wrong with your stock, and you go buying a little bit more. So let's say you're buying 100 shares. You might break your buying up into 3 or 4 or 5 pieces. You might buy 20 shares on one day, 20 more shares on another day, and target an average price instead of going all in at once. And now what everyone will do is you will want to go stare at your account and pray and hope that it goes up. If you've timed it wrong or you have the wrong stock, it goes down. Now you panic and you sell it out. And now you do the same thing over and over again, as opposed to using the market's volatility to your advantage as an opportunity to try and capture stock. And it is completely unimportant, as long as you've picked the right stock, that you capture the absolute perfect low point. Many people try and capture the absolute perfect low point, and they sometimes end up missing out because they don't want to pay 1 cent more. And by taking this approach, the small slugs approach, you're buying a little bit every single day. You always have a little bit in cash. That way you always feel like, hey, this is an opportunity, as opposed to if you're all in and now you've got all the stock that's exposed to the market and the market fluctuates, you start to panic, you want to sell anytime it goes down. So those are the three things that I would tell you that most people do not do because they've never really been told how to build a portfolio rather than just take a shot on goal with one single stock. So just to recap, never make an all-in bet on any single stock. Second, hold a portfolio of a minimum of 5 stocks, a minimum of 5 stocks. Yes, and I know my stuff portfolio does violate it. However, we were trying to create an acronym, and you can add an additional stock of your of whatever kind you can, whatever one you want to it if you wish. The Sticks portfolio, of course, has enough stocks in it. And the third thing is to really spread your buying out over a number of days. If you're buying a large position, do it over a number of weeks. Or if it's a very large position, truthfully, if you're a manager that's managing a lot of money, you would do it over a number of months. The idea is to try and capture the lowest price that you can, and a target, an average target price. And that way, when your stock soars higher, you get the benefit of all those gains. So that's my bold profits for you today. Please subscribe to our channel. Give us a thumbs up. You can also follow me on Twitter at ManpiliGuru, and I'll have another one of these for you next week. Until then, this is Paul saying bye.